Welcome to VentureF0rth. As we like to say in our sign outside, welcome to the neighborhood. If you want to learn more about VentureF0rth, we have lots going on all the time. Our new website will be up next week, and you can get all the details. But just in the next 2 weeks or so, we have an entrepreneurs only event coming up this Friday. We are hosting, we think, one of the first ever meetups of people interested in creating a cannabis technology industry. That's happening on the 18th. And then we actually have a whole series of joint programs that we are launching in conjunction with Philadelphia Magazine. The first series of these programs will be here, and they'll be featuring one-on-one interviews with the major mayoral candidates who will be asked, among other things, to talk about their vision for the future of technology here in Philadelphia. Melissa, do you remember when the first date is?
It's the 23rd or 24th of February.
23rd.
Anyway, you'll see on the calendar. We have a whole series of meetings that are coming up, and we hope you'll come back and participate. We also have Girls Development here tomorrow. For the last 4 weeks, we had PSL's learning program hosted here, and a lot more to come. I wanted to, this evening, or afternoon, it's always, your time somewhere. I wanted to first by talking a little, by sort of talking about the importance of setting long-term goals, keeping perspective, being persistent, and then a little bit about my passions and how they've led me to what I'm currently doing. Almost 38 years ago, I started a company called Telebase Systems in Northern Pennsylvania. We had as our goal, and this was, by the way, long before the internet, to provide easy access to remote databases to help better mankind, business databases, scientific databases. This was around the era of the Apollo program. And in fact, many of you may or may not know that the entire online industry as you know it, the entire online database systems as you know it, all began as a byproduct of the Apollo program. We got people to the moon in 10 years because we invented giant computers and software systems like stairs, which allowed us to search those systems, and then dedicated communications networks like Telenet and Tynet, which were the precursors, the components, the backbone that eventually became the internet. 38 years ago, I started a business. We wanted to provide world access to all this information. We created a system which if you had the right dial-up network, would give you access to all these wonders, and all you needed as your user device was something called a telex machine. Anybody ever heard of a telex machine? Maybe seen them in museums? Now, telex machines were really amazing for their time. And by the way, this was the earliest instantiation of cloud computing, because telex machines were absolutely stupid. You put tapes into them, they put tapes out. It was pretty rudimentary stuff. That was the first coming of cloud computing. Anyway, the telex machines accessing our network out of our offices in Narberth, which by the way, at the time we were featured in Business Week as being the technical leaders of our age, telex machines were accessing us at 75 baud. That's like dot. If you wanted to download an article, it'd take about 2 or 3 days. But to me, it was the second coming. And I couldn't understand why every household in America wasn't going to get a telex machine and start accessing all this stuff. I've been accused of being a little ahead of my time, but I haven't. My persistence and my vision have sustained themselves. Anyway, fast forward, a couple tens of years, Telebase Systems became a company which became CB Now, which was a really internet company. A few years before the internet actually launched, I started Infonautics. I had my first employee intern, a young fellow who's done pretty well investing in companies around the world since then. And if you don't know what I'm referring to, then you'll have to ask somebody. But I've had a lot of wonderful people work for me over the years, and he's just one of the many, many wonderful talents that I've been blessed to have in my employ. But anyway, 3 years before the internet, and who knew the internet was coming, we had an online service which was operating at maybe 9,600 baud. Big deal back then. And by the way, there were people when the 9,600 baud modem came out said it's the end of history. No ever invented application that can use more than this bandwidth. Nonetheless, we invented an online information service called Home with Helper. We launched on CompuServe, not Prodigy. We developed all this wonderful technology and infrastructure, spent tens of millions of dollars, which was completely obsolete as soon as the internet launched. And as my former intern likes to say, you know, you can take the $30 million of hardware, software, and systems we developed back then from scratch, including natural language interfaces, and basically you can finance it now on your credit card for $100 a month. So, a year ago, I gave a presentation for City Council, for the City Council of Philadelphia, David O's committee. And the topic was, you know, why not gigabit access here in Philadelphia? You know, you've got gigabit access in places like South Korea and Singapore and a lot of countries in Europe, whereas the United States, the average access is, you know, more like 6 minutes.
Right? Not to get a question, but we're at 5 minutes. You've got another 5 minutes because you've got two slots to talk about VentureF0rth and the record. So,
okay.
Since the two are intertwined, we go.
Yes, look, I took a few minutes to talk about, I mean, the vent.
I know.
Out. All right. Anyway, I talked about the value, the importance of the gigabit power.
You've got future. 5 more minutes and then 3 minutes for Q&A.
Okay. Fast forward to a week ago, we signed an agreement with Comcast. They have selected two dozen locations around the country, VentureF0rth being one, where they're going to install gigabit speed internet. They're going to create a broadband laboratory here at VentureF0rth. We'll have the fastest internet access outside of what Google's doing in Pittsburgh, we'll have the fastest internet access. Cisco is their partner. They're going to be installing gigabit Wi-Fi, as well as something called low-power Bluetooth, which we can talk about. It's crazy, wild stuff. But it took 38 years to get to gigabit speed, which, by the way, is roughly 2.5 million times faster than the access speed of the devices I was using in my first company. And you know, I think the people will come up, will not only embrace gigabit access, find things to do with it, but more and more. All I can say is I have a lot of history, about predicting these things. So that's about having a dream, being persistent, and thank you, Comcast. Now, what about the rest of, Pennsylvania? But we're glad to have it. So some of my passions. One of my passions is music and art. I'm a professional violinist by training. You may have noticed the piano. We are, in the events that we're going to be hosting upcoming, we're going to be featuring young prodigies, from musical prodigies, dancers from throughout the community to perform in the start of these events. We hope to set a new standard for mixing the arts, creativity, culture, technology. I actually currently volunteer at something called Musicians on Call, where every couple of weeks I perform for kids in the hospitals with they follow me down the corridors and stuff with my violin. It's a lot of fun. We also have just opened up an art gallery here. If any of you know young, wonderful musicians, artists who are looking to display, we've got lots of wall space, just finished painting. We're glad to put up their art. We're also glad to have musicians come here and perform. My second passion is a passion it's my love for America. I recently started and put my money into a company called American Certified, world's largest marketplace for American products. As of today, 3 million products, 40,000 manufacturers. We're just about to relaunch the interface after 5 months of beta. That's what we call it because we never really liked the interface, but the next one is going to be it. Anyway, stay tuned for next week, AmericanCertified.com. This passion, I come by this passion, honestly. My mother, may she rest in peace, was born in the Warsaw Ghetto. Those of you who know your history, life for Jews in the Warsaw Ghetto was not so great. She came to this country, and notwithstanding anti-Semitism and all these obstacles put in the face of Jews and other immigrants, to her, it was like nothing. I mean, people weren't actively trying to murder her every day, so she thought it was like a garden of Eden. I started American Certified because, for me, America is like a light unto the nations. And if I can build a business which helps American workers and American companies to help the American economy, to strengthen America's backbone, then to me, I'm really helping to further my mother's and my father's passion and love for this country and all that it represents. Another, and I hope you share those passions as well. Another passion of mine is philanthropy and giving back. That's why I bought VentureF0rth all of 3 months ago, and I decided to make a virtual necessity. Since it was already not profitable, I decided to go official about it and just make it not-for-profit. It is now officially not-for-profit. One of the things that is making it not-for-profitable, but hopefully this will change, is we've now opened up our space to a lot of young, wonderful startups who we hope to encourage to grow, and in the process, you know, they'll be able to eventually pay rent, which will help us to then bring more people in. My good friend from Bestimators is one of the 9 companies now formally within our accelerator space. We also are pleased that we're about to announce the launch of something called the Learning Annex, and Sylvester, Mobley, who many of you may know from Coding for Kids, just took up occupancy today. He's now another one of the nonprofits that we are sponsoring here at no cost. We hope working around his program, while we continue to provide no cost education for kids and underprivileged, we hope to expand that into a comprehensive program for the underprivileged, for veterans, for others from throughout the community, and for those who can pay at a fraction of what they would normally pay in the outer world. We hope to provide really comprehensive computer literacy education so that Comcast will have people to employ, you know, to meet their needs in the next years. Final passion, making money. It's important to make money. My wife, my kids like it, you know, it helps me buy things and they enjoy, but it also provides the fuel that allows me to do the things, these other passions, the things I'm passionate about. So I've also launched, in parallel to the VentureF0rth Foundation, the VentureF0rth Fund. It's a for-profit seed fund. As of today, we're $25,000 short of the minimum we've set to be able to be a big concern, at which point we'll spend all the money we've raised so far and invest it in, well, companies like Bestimators and some of the other 9 companies here. If you are looking to participate in a seed fund, we would be glad to have you come and talk to us about that. Thank you so much for allowing me to share my passions, my dreams, some of my visions, and I look forward to meeting you.
Sure, we've got 3 minutes.